After a long way from home, can't sleep at night, grab your telephone, something just ain't right. That's evil. Evil is going on wrong. I am warning you, brother. You better watch your channel.
That's it.
The record's a sort of a forgotten medium in a way, and they're coming back strongly, but still there's older people out there who still see them as MP3s is a new thing, so get rid of your records, you know, and that's good for us because, you know, the people that do appreciate records will still come here and buy them. I think the most prized records I have are records that have influenced me, like I've listened to it a certain occasion and it's opened my mind and made me think about like that genre that I never knew about, you know. The community in Berhampore, I like to be part of that, it's good. Like, I was a little too because it was such an awesome community, and to me, like, religion's a load of crap. All you need in society is a good community, and it's the basis of anything for happiness. Like, as long as you feel like you're part of something, then CDs came out. CDs came up and they're slowly going down, and you know, they're not selling as much. MP3s will go up, and then next there'll be a new smaller file system that's easier to download. But records seem to have had they rose at the beginning, they dropped, and then they sort of plateaued.
Well, I picked up Animal Folk Songs sung by Pete Seeger for $5 over at Evil Genius. They've got a $5 bin, which is pretty kick ass.
The digital era is not helping the music industry at all. I mean, once you've got a record that's the whole album, that's automatically up in the bank, you've got to go out and get that album, and then you've listened to the album as a piece rather than just a single. I think at the end of the day, they will always be around, and they won't even end up in the end, because there's bands these days still pressing new albums, they're loving the format, you know? It's definitely a thing you want as a band to have as a record.
Like that.
So I don't think records will ever become a museum.